I am Dr. Alpesh Dafda, and in this 9th video class of DIP, we will understand image negatives, log and power law transformations for digital image processing and its implementation in MATLAB. So as the name suggests, image negative will produce a negative image. That means the white values will become black and black values will become white. Log transformation and power law transformations are two different type of intensity transformations in which we are either increasing the intensity of pixel values or either decreasing the intensity of pixel values for different applications. So let us start. So very first is image negative. So negative image means inverting the grayscale values or gray levels. That is, black in the original image will become white and vice versa. Digital negatives are useful in a lot of applications. A common example of digital negative is the X-ray image, right? So the transformation for this image negative can be given by S is equal to L minus 1 minus R. So what we are doing, we are reversing the intensity levels of an image, and in this manner we are producing the equivalent of a photographic negative. So S, as you know from our previous classes, is the output intensity level, L is the highest intensity level, and R is the input intensity level. So this equation comes from the equation S is equal to T of R, which we saw in the previous video class. So this is nothing but a type of intensity transformation or point processing. So we are extending the point processing techniques discussed in the previous class in this video class. So this image negative is particularly suited for enhancing white or gray details embedded in dark regions of an image, especially when the black areas are dominant in size. So for image negative, log transformation or power law transformation, this figure is very important. If you understand this figure, you will understand everything that what is happening. So see, for this graph, this is 0 and this is L minus 1. So as it is an 8-bit image, 2 raised to 8, which is equal to 256, are total number of L. So if L is 256, L minus 1 is 255. And this is 0, of course. This again is 255. So you know from our previous video classes, 255 means white and 0 means black. So this again is white. So what is the transformation function for image negative? S is equal to L minus 1 minus R. This is our input value, R, and this S is our output value. So S is equal to L minus 1 minus R. Say for example, our input level is 0. So S will be equal to L minus 1 minus 0, and L minus 1 is 255, which is equal to 255. So if this R is 0, which is equal to black, S is equal to 255, which is equal to white. So if R is 0, that is black, S, that is output, is 255, that is white. That means image negative. Converse is also true for 255. Let us say R is equal to 255. So S will be equal to L minus 1, which is equal to 255, minus of, what is R? R is 255, right? Which is equal to 0. So when R is 255, S is 0. R, input intensity, is 255. S, you can see S is equal to 0. So this line shows image negative. Similarly, all different gray level values will be inverted. Okay. So the example of use of image negative is shown over here. This figure shows a digital mammogram which is showing a small lesion or tissue damage, you can say. So you can see over here that when you use image negative, this lesion is easier to see and detect as compared to the original image. So that is the application of image negative. So when we implement image negative in MATLAB, if this is our original image, you will see the negative image or complement image will be like this. So the black portion will become white and the white portion will become black. Let us implement this in MATLAB. Initially, I am reading my image, which is a color image, and converting that image into a grayscale image. Going further, the portion for image negative, as we have discussed in the previous class, whenever we are doing arithmetic operation on an image, we have to convert it into double. So I'll be converting into double my original grayscale image I by id is equal to double of I, and then image negative is l minus 1 minus r, and you know l minus 1 is 255. Okay, so I am writing here 255 minus of input intensity value. I'll be displaying my original image and the negative image side by side, and you know that when you have converted it to double using the double command, you have to use unsigned integer 8 command. So let us run this portion of the program and see the output. So of course you can see the original image and the negative image. So we can also perform this image negative using the inbuilt MATLAB command, that is im complement. I will be disabling this portion and I will enable these lines. So now my I negative is equal to im complement of I. Now I am directly taking I. Why? Because I am using inbuilt MATLAB command or inbuilt MATLAB function im complement, image complement. That means I need not use the double image. I will use my original I image. And similarly, while displaying this, I need not use unsigned integer 8. Let us perform it. And you can see here our original image and the negative image. So all the values are complemented. So in this way also you can perform image negative by using inbuilt MATLAB command or function that is more feasible. So next are the log transformations. So log transformation is an intensity transformation function or point processing function that is given by the equation S is equal to C into log of 1 plus R, where you know that R is your input intensity value and S is your output intensity value. C is a constant. So what this log transformation will do, it will map a narrow range of low intensity values in the input to a wide range of output levels. And opposite is true for higher values of input levels. So it expands the values of dark pixels in an image while compressing the higher values pixels. It compresses the dynamic range of images with large variations in the pixel values. So it maps a narrow range of low intensity values in the input into a wide range of output levels. So let us see again the same figure. This is your input and this is your output, right? And this is your log function. Okay. So for this log function, you can see here that when your input value is low, that is nearer to black, your output value becomes much brighter. Okay. That is whiter. The output value is white when the input value is low. That means the darker regions will become brighter. Therefore, it is said that it maps a narrow range of low intensity values in the input into a wide range of output levels. And the opposite is true for high values of input pixels. So it expands the values of dark pixels in an image while compressing the higher level values. We are compressing the higher level values. You can see here that the higher level values are compressed. It reduces the contrast of brighter regions. Okay, so the contrast will be reduced or the region will become more bright when we perform log transformation of an image. And of course the opposite is true for inverse log. So it comes out to be like this. So see, this is your original image. When you use a log factor of 2, you can see the image has become brighter. For 3, it is again has become more brighter, and for log factor 4, it has become still brighter. So you can see here the handle of the storage compartment is not visible, but when you perform log operation, you can see the handle of this storage compartment here as well as here more clearly. So let us perform this in MATLAB. This portion shows log transformation function. So I am converting my image to a double image. So see, we can even convert to double data value image by using im to double command, which is inbuilt command of MATLAB. So whenever you are using im to double, you need not use unsigned integer 8. See, here we are using double of I, and therefore you need to use unsigned integer 8 while displaying the image. But if you are using im to double command, you need not use unsigned integer 8 while displaying the image. So initially log image, I am assigning a value of 0, then I am finding out the size of my image and storing into the different values of rows and columns. So this will give me the number of rows and columns. I am using a constant C, which is equal to a factor of 3. Then I will be using a for loop in which I will loop from 1 to row, the maximum values of rows, and inside it 1 to column. That means I will go pixel by pixel, I'll be storing the log transformation in the equation log of ij, which is equal to c, that is your 3, which we have chosen here, into 1 plus input value. I'll be using a subplot for displaying the original image and the log transform image of factor 3. So let us run this program, or rather run this portion and see the output. So you can see here my log transform image. So rather than using these loops and performing it mathematically, I can also perform it directly in this manner. So I'll be converting the image into a double image, then I'll be using different values of c. Here c is 2, then 3 and 4, and into log of 1 plus r. But remember, whenever you are performing like this, you have to do element to element transformation. Okay, so each and every element should be covered, or each and every pixel should be covered, and therefore rather than simply using multiplication, I'll be using dot multiplication, and then I'll be subplotting. Let us run this portion in MATLAB, and you can see here, this is my original image, this is log factor 2, log factor 3 and log factor 4, and as we go towards higher end, you can even clearly see the handle of the storage box. Let us go ahead and understand power law or gamma transformation function. So this point processing is given by S is equal to C into R raised to gamma. R is the input, S is the output, C is your constant, and gamma is your power law function. Gamma between 0 to 1, it maps a narrow range of dark input values into a wider range of output values, similar to the log function, you can see, right? And with the opposite being true for higher values of gamma, that is gamma greater than 1 for input levels. So when both C and gamma is equal to 1, it means that it is an identity transformation function. So what is the importance of this gamma transformation? Variety of devices used for image capturing, printing and display respond according to a power law or gamma law, and process to correct this power law response phenomena is called gamma correction. So this power law will enhance this contrast of brighter regions. So this log was reducing the contrast of brighter regions. See here, these are the brighter regions, and the contrast is reduced as you go ahead, right? Whereas the power law enhances contrast of brighter regions, right? So what is the importance of this power law function? So a variety of devices that are used for printing and display responds according to the power law or gamma, and therefore gamma correction is needed. For example, the CRT devices have an intensity to voltage response, that is power function, with exponents varying from approximately 1.8 to 2.5, right? So see this curve for gamma is equal to 2.5. You can see that display systems will tend to produce images that are darker than intended. Why? Because you can see here, the log was increasing the brightness, whereas the gamma is decreasing the brightness. For this particular value of gamma, you can see, if this is your input value, your input is much higher, and you can see that your output is much lower, okay, or darker, and therefore gamma correction is needed. So this figure shows the input intensity level and output intensity level for various values of gamma, and C is kept at 1. So for gamma is equal to 5, okay, for more brighter regions the output will be darker, and for gamma less than 1, for more darker regions of the input, the output will be brighter, just like the log function. So why this gamma correction is important? You can see this is the intensity ramp image which is displayed on a monitor with a gamma of 2.5. so you can see the actual intensity value is different, and what is displayed is much darker. Why? Due to this particular gamma of 2.5. so we need to carry out the gamma correction, and the gamma corrected image before going to the monitor is much lighter than the original image. Why? Because you have to do the reverse processing. So you are now decreasing the intensity values. Why? Because when it will be displayed, it will again become darker as original, right? So here we are doing gamma correction and decreasing the intensity values, and when you are giving this to the same monitor, it will be displayed as darker. So this is gamma corrected image as viewed on the same monitor. But what is important over here, you can see the first image and the last image. So first image is your original image that you want to display, and the last image is the image displayed on the same monitor using gamma correction. So now your input is same as output. after gamma correction. But if you have not done gamma correction, then it will be displayed much darker. So let us see the result of this gamma correction for different values of gamma of 3, 4 and 5 and see that is constant is equal to 1. You can see here this aerial image is much brighter over here and you cannot see different portions or different houses properly. So applying the gamma correction of 3, you can see that the houses and other things are visible more nicely now, even the water. And if you still apply more gamma correction, it will still be better to view. And for this gamma correction, you can see that some of the details are lost towards this side as well as towards this side. So optimal gamma value needs to be chosen for gamma correction. So if this is my original image, so if I am applying gamma correction to this original image, I can see some of the parts which are not having good contrast and make them darker. For example, say this display board. So the display board is not properly visible over here. You can see this display board more correctly over here. Again, you can see here the improvement in the results. And of course, the optimum value is gamma 4. Let us implement this in MATLAB. So again, we will be performing gamma correction using the arithmetic procedure. Let us run this portion. So you can see for gamma factor of 3, you can see this display board properly. Even the same transformation function can be performed easily using this procedure. Let us run this section and see the output. Of course, you can compare this gamma factor 3 image with the earlier result that we just saw. So you can see here that now this display board is more properly visible after gamma correction. Now let us see the results for gamma less than 1, an application for gamma less than 1. So you can see this is a magnetic resonance image of a fractured human spine at this particular portion. So you cannot see the fracture properly. And if you go for gamma less than 1, that is gamma is equal to 0.6, 0.4 and 0.3, you can see clearly the fracture. So we can even use gamma less than 1 values, which will be acting like log transformation functions. So for gamma less than 1, the image will become more brighter. For this particular application, you can see now you can correctly see the compartment box of the car, the handle of the compartment box of the car in this image and this image. So let us perform this in MATLAB. I am again using the similar program. So let us run this section and see the output. So you can see here for different gamma factors of 0.6, 0.4 and 0.3, you can see how the results are. Here the handle is more properly visible. So that is how you perform different intensity transformation function or point processing functions such as image negative, log transformation and power law transformation. So that is all for this video class. Thank you very much.